Hi, welcome to another episode of Power Up. My name is Purity Kamande, a nutritionist, and today we shall be talking about eating for weight loss. So how do you go about eating and at the same time losing weight? It's usually very simple. We refer to something as a calorie deficit, whereby you're burning more than what you're eating in. And this deficit is basically what will cause you to lose weight. So let's just demystify a few myths that usually surround thing that is weight loss. You'll hear person to person usually saying, don't eat this, don't do this, don't eat this particular food at this particular time. So do all this work, and what is the science behind them? In nutrition, we usually say, if there is no science to back it up, if there is no evidence-based research to back it up, most of the time it is snake oil being sold to you. So this thing of no carbs after a certain period of time, it's usually very hard not to eat any fruit that does not contain carbohydrates. Almost 90% of all foods, regardless of food group, contain a particular amount of carbohydrates. So eliminating carbohydrates most of the time from a diet is usually close to impossible. The only way that you can come close to this is embracing a low carb diet, and this is usually done by the guidance of a nutritionist or a dietitian, or under the prescription of a physician because of a particular disease or condition one may have. So it is quite impossible to totally eliminate carbohydrates from your diet. Another myth that people talk about is drinking lemon water for weight loss. That does not work. A simple example we usually give is, take your hot water and lemon and put it on a fatty piece of meat. Does that fat dissolve? No, it does not dissolve, because that is not how weight loss works. The way that you can initiate fat loss is usually by a number of ways. Number one is what I meant by a calorie deficit. Number two, put protein in every meal that you're eating. Do not skip out on your protein, especially when it comes to weight loss. Protein tends to offer a higher quality energy compared to other foods, and it gives you and keeps you fuller for longer compared to carbohydrates. Another thing we say, especially when you want to burn fat, is exercising at least 3 times a week and switching up your exercise routines with the guidance of a fitness trainer who is able to understand what your needs are and what your goals are at the end of the day. And we also say, how much are you sleeping? As we mentioned in an earlier episode, your sleep is very important, especially when it comes to weight loss. So opt for 7 to 9 hours or 6 to 8 hours of quality sleep each and every night for your body to be able to recover and rest, and for you to be able to even cater for the craving that comes with insomnia, especially for high fatty foods. Another thing we usually say, especially when it comes to weight loss, be consistent and enjoy your journey. If you are on a weight loss program that is very restrictive, not sustainable, most of the time you will not enjoy it. And if you don't enjoy it, you'll find it as a punishment. And with this, then it will become very troublesome and a burden for you to be able to do it. But if it's something that you're enjoying to do and you can't look for and you can look forward to it every other day, then it works for you and it will be easy for you to even embrace it after a long time. The next thing that we talk about, especially when we're talking about weight loss, hereby we say embrace your vegetables and fruit. Ideally, half of your plate should be vegetables if you're looking to lose weight, because vegetables tend to occupy a lot of volume in the stomach and they also take a longer time to digest compared to carbohydrates. And if you're eating more of your vegetables, it means you're fuller for longer and you won't feel hungry after a short time compared to eating just carbs after a short time. You're back to the kitchen eating again, which impedes the gains that you're making, especially when it comes to weight loss. So embrace your vegetables, either the fresh ones or the frozen ones, then it gives you adequate amount of food to be able to keep you fuller for longer. Even with vegetables as a way of losing weight, there tends to be two groups of these particular vegetables. Here we have your starchy and your non-starchy vegetables. All of them are vegetables. The only difference that comes in between is amount of calories that each group of vegetables has to offer. You will find that starchy vegetables tend to offer more calories because of the high amount of starch that is found in them. Starch is an example of a complex carbohydrate. And examples of starchy carbohydrates are, one, potatoes, peas, beans, which tend to be very high in starch. and they with this then higher in starch, higher in carbohydrates, higher in calories. Non-starchy vegetables contain higher amounts of nutrients compared to the calories that they pack. Examples of non-starchy vegetables are broccoli, your celery, your cucumber, your courgettes, your eggplants, your celery. All these are examples of non-starchy vegetables. And especially when you're looking to lose weight, this is a group that should be a good friend of yours because the calories tend to be lower and they tend to keep you fuller for longer. No particular group of vegetables is bad. You just need to look out for the portions that you're taking, especially when it comes to starchy vegetables. Both groups are fine. Just look out for the portions when it comes to starchy vegetables because the amount of calories that they have. Because higher in calories means that you're not adhering to your calorie deficit. So you just need to keep it within the balance, what is enough for you at a particular time. So that has been another episode of Power Up. My name is Purity Kamande. My contact and social media handles are below. Reach out and let's talk more about nutrition.